First of all, I want to draw your attention on our point, because I think it's important. Maybe you are expert and you understand this, but usually I think industrial heritage is not enough evaluated. Sometimes it looks like the poor brother of the heritage, and I think it deserves a more important attention. But another thing important is that blast furnace is the heart of the steel and iron industry. This is not a normal building. This is not a building where we can put a new use, more or less appropriate for its characteristics. This is a huge element, an impressive element, that serves for an industrial process. In this element, human ingenuity shows its ability to know, to master, and to change nature. So, if we add to this characteristic of its commemorative character, its incredible image, and its possibility of restoration, we've got here an authentic 20th century industrial masterpiece. This is not less than cathedrals or castles or baroque theaters. I think we are facing a very important piece of our culture. Okay, the number two blast furnace is the most important remain of the old iron and steel industry of Orbe Segund. Well, I make my presentation in four parts. First, I will give you a bit of history. Then I explain you our source of inspiration for the project, and finally the work really carried out. Well, the steel and iron industry started in Port de Segund in 1917, and in 1926 the number two blast furnace was working. We can see here number one, number two, and it were up to three blast furnaces working here. And here we can see the whole factory. In this picture, we can note some important things. The first is, of course, the factory, this big here. There are two elements very important for the factory, the port and the railway here. Well, the port and the railway were the elements that made come here the industry, because the port was used for the boats, brought the coal, the trains brought the mineral, and here they made the iron that was spotted by the port and by the railway. Well, there is two here, far away in the landscape, the old city, the historical city of Segund, with its Romanic and Islamic past. And here we can see the new town of Port de Segund. Port de Segund is a town born with the industry. Everything here, houses, school, churches, bars, everything was made for the workers of the factory. And the factory was gave its sense to the city. Really, the factory made the rhythm of the life of the city. So, we have in mind important thing that by recovering the remains of the industry, we are recovering the memory of this city. And this is important because I think our main material in our work was not steel or brick or concrete, but memory. Well, this is the best time for the factory, because after the 60s it started to decline, and finally in 1984 it closed after a strong workers' struggle, and thousands of people were fired. Well, and the factory, look here at the factory, with the number two blast furnace standing here in the middle of nothing. Looking yesterday presentation of Mr. Moles, I remember this image because this is not the same, but the destruction of the memory, not like a weapon, but because economical reasons, could be very, very hard too for a population. Well, and this is that first we found on which tower, 64 meters high. This is like a 20 flat building and completely rusty. Here, the high pipes. This is our first visit to the blast furnace, and we feel here like in the bowel of the monster. We are here, younger. And this picture taken from the top of the blast furnace shows how the road was almost touching the base of the blast furnace. And this is the surface of the barrel of the blast furnace with the cooling box, completely rusty and very difficult to conserve, I think. Well, this is the work platform in reinforced concrete, destroyed concrete, really. And the frightening cracks in the crucible that we draw. But the worst thing, I think, was the urban situation. This is the plan. And here you can see the blast furnace in a strange, small, and really odd roundabout. I don't know who could draw this. Because this roundabout was not able to house the whole working platform. Look here, and look here, the foundation that were under the road. Well, at this point, I want to tell you that the blast furnace is not a single element. The blast furnace is really the heart of a big complex, a complex for producing. And the other elements of this, here you can see the process, and here the other elements that have been around the blast furnace. So these elements are very important for understanding the process. We had a commitment to recover the blast furnace in an educational way. So it's very difficult to explain it, because when you look this, you can think this is a big coffee pot, I don't know, because it's difficult to understand. Sometimes it's difficult to see, because if you don't know the words for everything here, you say, but what's this? And it's really difficult. But this was what we had. And was exactly this powerful image the first source of inspiration for our work? Because we thought that industrial images have provided inspiration for all the vanguards that in the earliest 20th century built the modernity. So these industrial images are inside our culture. These are our aesthetic, really, think about it. So we find it, every vanguard drank of this source. For example, here, Neutra, here, Tatlin, Lisitsky, in this strange picture. And to the colors, look here, Malevich, the colors of the blast furnace were the colors of the modernity. Well, we had another second source of inspiration, of course, the other works that were being undertaken in that moment in Europe. Exactly in Germany. This is Neunkirchen, where some elements were conservated here, like the blast furnace, Heter, and all this, or Duisburg. Duisburg is a humankind heritage, where the whole factory has been conservated. And the intervention were not on the element, but in the spaces, in a very interesting landscape way. But the main source of inspiration for us came from the blast furnace itself, because we had a doubt. We liked, we enjoyed the image, the rusty image of the blast furnace, but we thought Is it possible to consider this? How we can do it? And is it useful in this educational way that we want to conserve it? So, in that point, the blasphemies came to help us, because we have to know that a blasphemy, like every element, is not like a pyramid standing there for being to be seen by the centuries. A blasphemy is more like the Japanese temple of Ise. This Japanese temple, built in the 5th century, I think, is very old, but it's always new, because since the 7th century, it's renewed every 20 years in a religious ceremony. Well, blasphemy is rebuilt every 5 years in an industrial ceremony. And this is a non-stone machine. They start the blasphemy, and it works and works and works, day and night. Then, about 5 years later, when the refractory inside is completely burned, they stop, they demolish, and they reconstruct it. Sometimes, the reconstruction is only the interior. Sometimes, other structures, and sometimes, the whole blast furnace. The last complete reconstruction of the number 2 blast furnace takes place in 1961. Here we can, and it produces the blast furnace that we can see today. These are the round, big, strong foundation. Here, the barrel, and finally, this image. It's interesting to look at this, because they built the whole blast furnace in only 3 years, and we spent 16 years for restoring it. I don't know what we do. Well, this is the image that we wanted to recover, the optimistic image of a blast furnace completely renewed and ready to start to work, not to produce iron, but to transmit knowledge. Well, we had another important source of information in the files of the factory. These files are now property of the Foundation for the Industrial Heritage of Sagunto, that is the owner of the blast furnace, and they are now making visits and all this to the blast furnace. And we get information, for example, about structures around the blast furnace, and this allowed us to reconstruct virtually or physically the elements here, look here and here, around the blast furnace. And we could decide with this what we wanted to show. Well, with all these materials, we made and designed our project. In our project, we acted in 3 levels. We are really Vitruvian architects, because we acted on structural reinforcement, of course. We acted recovering the image in the way we've seen before. And we acted, too, on the functional rehabilitation of the blast furnace. In this part, we make, first, we get more space for the roundabout. Now, the foundation are inside the roundabout. Then, in this new space, we rebuild some important elements around the blast furnace, important for making it easy to understand. Well, we make 2 reception pavilion, very important for controlling the access, and we make a access square here for housing the visitors. Then when we finish that, we connected the roundabout with the central space of the road here in order to get a comfortable pedestrian access. And finally, we put here a new because we made it new, but it was made always with recycled material, is a railway. This railway around the blast furnace has to connect in the future the blast furnace, because we finish here, with the Museum of Industrial Heritage of Saguntum for making a better visit. This museum is now finished, but it's not open. You know how is the economical situation in Spain. Okay, here in this section, we can see the
five main actions that we make in the blast furnace. We can make here, before, later, and we make five things. So we recover the original level of the factory, because this is the level now of the new industrial area. We made the new access pavilion. We reconstruct the two big cranes here, because the blast furnace is a directional element. It's not only a cylinder like a tower. We emptied the inside and we made it visitable. And finally, we reconstructed, in an analogical way, of course, this slope of the loading skip of the blast furnace in order to house a new elevator that in this moment the council is working for get the money and make it. We decided to which levels could be visitable. And here, the pavilion. The pavilion is made in two blocks. One closed block with audiovisual facilities for, yeah, this is very important for the memory, because people, when arrive, usually doesn't know anything about the blast furnace, so they can't see the factory because it doesn't exist. So here, people take information. So this is an industrial thing where people is processed, and people enter here without knowing anything, and go out through here knowing something that will allow them to understand that they are going to visit. This open block house the circulation, connect a tour around the base of the blast furnace and the services. The section, well, this form are not only plastic but functional, because this is the audiovisual space, and these are the stairs for connecting the two outer level of the blast furnace. Finally, the skin of the pavilion is made with concrete scales. These concrete scales are the same in the two blocks of the pavilion. So we made a ventilated facade for the closed block of the pavilion and a lattice for the open one. These two are a very good solution for the usually hot and sunny weather of Sagunto. Well, finally, this is the work really carried out. We can see here, the blast furnace is working, how we found it and how is it now. Here the barrel, before and now. We reconstructed the connection for the cooling of the for the cooling boxes. The high levels, before and now. A beautiful picture with the Mediterranean sky. From the top, before and now, we can see here the reception square, here the slope, here the railway. And now the road is not touching the base. We reconstructed the big cranes in order to recover the image, but to get a wonderful viewpoint on the over the region. We reconstructed the slope of the loading skip. This is the platform where the elevator will arrive. This is the drove elevator. It was the place where the blast furnace was charged. And this is a good viewpoint on Port de Sagunt. Well, a beautiful image in the sunset. We acted inside too. Before we wanted acted in the same way, reconstructing it. But when we go inside, it happened that everybody was felt in love with the refractory. So we conservated it. And this is the result of the inside with this structure that allow to visit it, because the floor is not very, very flat. We reconstructed and repaired the working platform, and this is the tour that we can make around the base of the platform, yes? The working platform with the doors for entering in the crucible. We reused a lot of things. For example, here, concrete sleepers for making the retaining wall between the two outer layers. And on the top of this wall, we put a fence made with recycled rails. This is the construction of the block, the closer one, the open one, with the scales. Here, the image of this outside, with some recovered elements, and this palm, because the work was stopped at almost 10 years. When we came back, we found that this palm was born here. Now we say, well, okay, she's living here. Let it live here. This is the reception square. Here, the inside of the closet block. Look here, the scales, in this big south window, protecting from the sun. And this is the open block, seen from the working platform. This inside this block, with this concrete lattice. And finally, this, very important, is the budget, of course. We made it in three phases, like I said, before the Ministry of Public Works was paying it, and then was the Sound Town Council who started to pay the work. Finally, a small budget, this is a real budget with VAT, with everything, and I think it's less than 3 million of euros. It's a small budget for work that returned to Port de Sagunt important part of its memory. And I finished. Thank you for your attention.